Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Mohammed Adnan, and in this video, we are going to discuss about how to extract the list of files available in a particular folder, and those lists can be copied into an Excel file. Yes, it is possible using Power Automate. We'll discuss this in this video. Stay tuned for that. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Let's get started. This is a Power Automate, and you have to sign into your personal account, official account, or a school account. So personal account, it is being stored on your OneDrive. If you're using the office account or a school account, then you have to create a database. If you want to know about Dataverse and database, you can check out my video, and that will be helpful if you're going to use the Power Apps and Power Automate. So now click on New Flow. I'm going to give a name. Extract files in a folder in Excel. So click on create. It open up a new window. So now here I'm going to select on the folders from the variables and drag and drop it over here. And here I'm going to select the folders. I'm going to select the same folder which I'm using it regularly. Here the base folder. Click on OK. I want to filter everything from it. So click on Save. Now at the bottom goes here Excel. So there's an option like launch an Excel file. If you want to open up on a blank Excel file, you can use it here. So it is asking for with a blank document or if you want to open an existing document. So if you want to launch a blank document, you can click here the blank document and make instance visible. Yes, okay, and then click on save. So it will open up a blank document, and then you have an option like write to Excel worksheet, right? So let me expand this a bit. Yeah, it's write to Excel worksheet. I'm just drag and drop this here. So here it's asking for the Excel instance. It has automatically taken here this Excel instance from the variable sections. If you look at the right side, Excel instance is there. And now it is asking for value to write, what need to write. If you want to type it manually, you can type it here. Or if you want to declare any variable, you can select here. Clicking on here, I'm going to the list of files. I'm going to use this one. So list of files, even you can type it manually, percentage the files, and then the percentage is going to take that value as well. So write mode, if you want to specify it on a particular column or row, you can select that. Or if you want to write it on the currently active cell. By default, if you open a new blank Excel file, it's going to be on A1. Let it be on the A1, that's not a problem for me. So click on save. So click on save now, and then run. So it gets list of files available in the folder, launching an Excel file and writing it to that. Yeah, here's the one. The new blank Excel file has opened up here on the A1. It has taken all the four files name which is available inside to that folder. That's amazing, right? Now if you want to specify that you want to make the list of only the text available inside to that, you can also do that by using the get folder. Click here and then enter, or you can edit here the file after, right? So you can file filter dot txt. And then click save. If you run this flow again, so the match is txt, it has given up here. I believe book 3 might be open here. Book 2 is there. Yeah, book 3 is there. So this is a book 3 and it has list out the value only about the text. This is an awesome thing, right? So this is how you can able to extract the list of files available inside to that folder in a separate Excel file. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure to turn on the notification on your devices. If you're not a member of our channel, just hit the join button to know in detail about it. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.